Welcome to RelyLocal Frederick Business Radio Spotlight. For the next 30 minutes, you will hear fast-paced interviews, unique perspectives, and valuable insight from real people who believe that empowering local business is everybody's business. This show is about the backbone of America, small businesses right here in and around the communities where we live, work, and play. And now, your host, Caressa Flannery, brings you RelyLocal Frederick's Business Radio Spotlight.
Hello, this is Caressa Flannery, your host for the RelyLocal Business Spotlight. And I'm sure a lot of people out there are wondering, what is RelyLocal? A healthy community depends on a healthy economy, and both completely depend on the local businesses in Frederick, Maryland. Simply put, more money spent with local businesses stays here, roughly about 68%, where much less money spent with national chains stays in the area, only about 14%. And money that's spent online, well, that simply leaves us forever. To us at RelyLocal, supporting local businesses doesn't stop with the economy. It's all about creating a stable and vibrant community. Frederick businesses create jobs, the tax revenue for schools and parks and roads, while offering diversity in the marketplace with unique products and services that are not found in any of those big box stores or chain restaurants. And not to mention, these local businesses are owned by the very people who sponsor our little leagues, donate to our local charities, and they volunteer for our community events, and they even sponsor them too. They give back to the community in countless ways. You rely on them, but can they rely on you? And did you know that every dollar you spend with a Frederick business stimulates our local economy? You don't have to break the piggy bank to support these local businesses either. Just refocusing $20 of your current spending toward local businesses instead of online, national, or big box merchants can have a major impact in the Frederick community. And folks, we are here today with Bonnie Schilling. Bonnie is the director of client engagement for Frederick Guerrilla Magazine. Welcome, Bonnie.
Thank you. I'm so glad to be here.
I know. I'm excited to have you here. And this is the first time Bonnie and I have met, and we're going to be just, you know, amazing friends. I have a feeling. We're going to get through this wonderful interview.
Yeah.
But, you know, Frederick Guerrilla, what a fun, it's just fun. You know, the name itself is fun.
It is.
It's very fun.
It's a very different magazine. It's not a lot of fluff. It has a little bit for everybody.
It's creating a buzz out there.
It is creating a buzz.
I mean, I love the tagline, you know, the whole tagline with the business, life, and politics. They tell it like it is, and
they
love
do.
That.
We want to be the gorilla in the room.
Exactly.
That's where it comes from.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we're a bi-monthly publication. We are really trying to involve all of Frederick and the surrounding areas within the publication. And we also, along with the bi-monthly magazine, we have a publication launch, which we're having tonight. So, you know, check our website for whenever the issue is launched. We have a great behind-the-cover scene. Events so you can meet the staff, the writers.
Yeah, and you do these events all the time, so that's good. You know,
we
as every, you know, publication comes out, it's good to know that these behind the cover, you know, events go on and
stuff. Yeah, and they're at one of the advertisers or one of the local venues, so we try to really introduce people throughout the community.
Yeah, it's definitely great. So tell us a little bit about, I guess, you know, just in general, you know, the stuff going on with Frederick Guerrilla. I mean, you know, the whole focus with the business and the life.
Yeah, it's, well, it's been around since 2011. We have purchased the magazine. I am with Graphcom Publishing. So it's exciting to be with them at this time. It's a growing magazine. It's getting more and more buzz every day. We not only have the publication that reaches Frederick, we have it. You can available in the App Store, so you can read on your tablet or your smartphone, and it's free. And that's the other big cool thing about the Guerrilla. We don't charge, so it's free. You can pick it up at your local
vendors.
There's no subscription.
Yeah,
correct.
Yeah.
And you can even subscribe to it and have it delivered to your house. It's free.
Yeah.
So, that's just a neat little side element. We're doing some really cool things within the business and life and politics. It's always things that are a little bit different, a little bit the spin, the businesses. We try to do the successes and the challenges, the good and the bad. You're not mm-hmm. just going to hear about, you know, everything is rosy. That's not life. So right. we get into a lot of things
exactly.
that
That's
you
what
don't
I said.
Typically
you know,
read.
They tell it like it is,
yeah.
you know? I
yeah.
mean, really, because just as you said, life is not always a bowl of cherries
yeah.
or like smelling roses. Sometimes we get up and we're grumpy.
It's true.
Life throws you curveballs sometimes.
And that's interesting too.
Yeah,
so that's why we really enjoy a lot of the stories that we get in. They're just interesting. They're a little out of the box.
They're cutting edge. They're edgy. And
yes.
and the editorial is just, it's really well done overall. I mean, from, you know, publication to publication and article to article that I've personally read, mm-hmm. you know, I think that is a great flair that the Frederick Gorilla has.
Yeah, we
really.
Have some great writers that have submitted, mm-hmm. so we're very excited.
I even submitted an
awesome.
Idea for an article too. So we'll see yeah. How that pans out. But yeah, it's just, you know, I think a lot of people didn't maybe totally understand it in the very beginning.
Yeah.
And, you know, I, like you pointed out, it's like the gorilla in the room, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, it is that one subject that nobody wants to talk about.
Yeah, and we talk about
and
it.
And you guys talk about it. And people appreciate that, I think, overall. I think that's you know, the best part about it. And, you know, as you mentioned, it's been around, well, as far as GraphCom, since 2011. I know, obviously, it was, you know, it was here, you know, prior to that. But ever since GraphCom's taken it over, I think it's really just, it's got a little bit different spin on it. And, you know, it's great. And, you know, one of the things that I wanted to just ask or throw out there, and I'm sure we'll, you know, get through it in this 30 minutes that we're together. But, you know, I love that Gorilla picks a different person for the cover. Mm-hmm. And it's not necessarily a nice person or a fun person, or, you know, it's somebody who's been out in the news and the media, you know, who's stirred up a little
controversy.
Little controversy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or, you know, it's just in the spotlight in some way.
We like to do that. We really like to pull in some things that are a little different and a little, mm-hmm. Like we said, a little controversial, or just a little, you know, something that's really in the spotlight for the moment, and we really want to highlight that person or group or artist or whatever it may be. So
yeah. I think they should put me on the cover, don't you?
Hey, submit it to us. We will definitely look at it.
God, no. Well, let's talk a little bit about, you know, how do you guys get your story ideas? I mean, obviously, you know, I shared that
we get them
sent
from
you. Yeah, you get them. No, you don't.
Well, we have a variety of ways we get them. We have an active readership. So mm-hmm. that's one thing that we really love about our readers. They're very active online. We get phone calls. We get letters. People pitch us items all the time, and mm-hmm. we love that. So that's something that you're going to see throughout the magazine, that they'll pitch us ideas that when they're out and about.
Yeah.
And, you know, something that we may not even know about.
Well,
so
actually, Bonnie,
great.
let's hold there, because we've already gotten to the first break. Can you believe it? So we're going to break, but we will pick up with that when
great.
We get back, okay? All right, and folks, don't forget, from Gettysburg to Brunswick and Hagerstown to Mount Airy, may the source be with you. This is Caressa. We'll be right back.
Now I'll get down the stairs. Clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right. Here I am, stuck in the middle with you. Yes, I'm stuck in the middle with you. And I'm wondering what it is I should do. It's so hard to keep this smile from my face.
Image means personality, and businesses, like people, have personalities. The right advertising can make or break you in the marketplace. WETCHCO Signs has what it takes to help you develop that winning image. WETCHCO Signs provides high-quality signage, displays, lettering, custom embroidered or screen-printed apparel, and graphics for all your personal, business, and organizational needs. With over 20 years of experience in the industry, WETCHCO Signs is a full-service signs company offering you the most innovative signage design, production, and superior installation. WETCHCO Signs will work with you to incorporate your image into the professional branding that tells your unique story.
WETCHCO Signs is the premier location for all your laser engraving needs. This amazing state-of-the-art technology can create one-of-a-kind trophies, plaques, awards, and gifts customized to your personal, sports, or professional needs with precision, detail, and accuracy. Just call 301-378-2216 or check out their website at WETCHCO.com.
What sets one realtor apart from others? Experience and attention to details. Stacy Allwine is a Long & Foster Executive Club top achiever with over 20 years of experience helping families find the right home. Her commitment is to you, and if that means hard work, then she is prepared to prove to you why she is one of the top realtors in this area. Call Stacy Allwine today at 301-606-6716 for all your real estate needs. Stacy Allwine is a proud sponsor of the champion Frederick Keys and a member of Rely Local Frederick.
Is your computer slow?
Then it should be going to Tech Junkies.
Tech Junkies will diagnose the issues and transform your system into a top-performing pro, and they can custom build you an entirely new one. Ask Tech Junkies about their remote services.
They can take over your system and do all the cleanups, defrags, and other diagnostics to save you time.
And their talented website design staff can create a beautiful site for your personal or business use. Check them out at techjunkies.com.
That's TECjunkies.com.
We left out the H because we left out the hype. Or call 240-288-8126.
Hello, we are back. This is Caressa with the Rely Local Business Spotlight. And folks, I want to just make sure that you all know that if you would like to send us any email feedback, questions, or interview suggestions, you are welcome to do that by sending that email to rlf@wthu.org, or you can call them here at the station at 301-637-6736. And also, just want to put a reminder out there that Rely Local Frederick MD is on Facebook, and of course you can visit our website at relylocal.com. But on Facebook, we would love to have you as a fan. We would appreciate that. And we are back with Bonnie Schilling. She's the Director of Client Engagement for Frederick Guerrilla Magazine. Very exciting publication.
Yes,
one of
the newest
publications, we should say, in the Frederick area.
Yes, we are.
Yes, and we were talking before the break about, you know, how you get your story ideas. So sorry to have to interrupt you, but
no problem.
You know, let's go into a little bit more detail with that, so folks know. You know,
sure.
Because you guys are open to story ideas.
Very open.
Yeah, because you know, you never know who knows about the controversial stuff out there.
That's so true.
You know, it's great.
Yeah, we rely. I think I mentioned right before the break. We have an active readership. So the people that read, they love to pitch us ideas because they're out and about, mm-hmm. and they're going to see things that we may never even see. We have some great editors. We have Mike Clem, who is our editor in chief, and then Michael Viscoso, he's our managing editor. They're always on the lookout. I mean, they will take an email, a call anytime, always looking for news stories. So we have some really great people that just love engaging with the readers.
And the wonderful thing about that is they really help the Frederick community make the magazine their own in a lot of ways. You know what I mean?
I think that's a really good
point.
Because I think if you don't involve your readers, what's the point?
Right.
I mean, the readers
you want them to read it.
Exactly. Yeah. So, you know, they get very excited. And then especially when they see their story or their photo or whatever it is, they, you know, it's exciting for everybody because it's truly a local magazine.
Yeah, definitely.
And then we have a great social editor. I'm sure everybody knows her, Jen Gerlach. She's actively online constantly working on the social media aspects, just taking full advantage of staying connected, getting the word out that we're here, and really, really has spearheaded the social side of Guerrilla. So we are so happy to have her. We love her. Mm-hmm. she's my new best friend. Mm-hmm. So let's see. We have some other, like lots of other social media tools. We're obviously on Facebook. You can find us there. We have over 1,800 likes, and it's growing. So it's really exciting to see the readers just very actively engage with each other. And so that's a place to go. Check us out. There's also, that'll keep you also informed with all the events, whether it's our behind the cover events or other community events. We like to post those as well.
Sure.
We also just introduced, we have a survey card in the magazine, so if you have ideas or stories or photos or anything that you want to pitch to us, you can do that via the magazine with a subscription card. So you can get to us pretty much anyway.
Yeah, and also I know on Facebook they have a group on there that's kind of represented as like a forum, you know, that people can entertain ideas and talk you know, about the latest issue and, you know, just put their feedback out there. I think that's great to open all those avenues for people
Absolutely.
To be able to engage with the magazine.
Absolutely.
So that's that's really great. So I know that Frederick Gorilla is, you know, they're very philanthropic, I guess we'll say, because they're very involved in the community. I mean, you hear their name a lot now, you know, when it comes to a lot of these different nonprofit events, or events, I should say, that benefit nonprofits and whatnot. So, you know, I guess maybe talk a little bit about, you know, what all the Gorilla's doing with that.
Sure. We do love giving back. The Frederick Gorilla is very, very vested in the community, and we realize it's just such an important part of what we do and who we are. I'll just name a few that we're involved with. The Frederick Women's Giving Circle, the CFFC, the Catoctin Affair.
Mm-hmm. And that's for the Mental Health Association.
Okay.
That's actually coming up, I think, in a few months.
It is coming up. Yeah. The IHA, Building Homes to Build Better Communities Through Affordable Housing. We're involved with them. Hartley House.
Yes, and that's for victims of domestic violence and for their families.
FDK Women's Civic Club, the Mardi Gras.
Oh, that sounds like fun.
It does. That's a party. That's a party. We all have to
exactly.
go. Buy your tickets now.
I know.
The YMCA Race Against Racism.
And the YMCA is all about families. I mean, that's, you know, they're definitely vested in the community. Yes. That's great.
And then last but not least, I'm sure that there's more that I haven't talked about, but we have Super Sunday, the Rescue Mission's Hunger Relief Program, which is a really important program. So that just taps into a few things. We do sponsor quite a few events that are around town, and we're just out. We're out and about.
And I know that they're, you know, doing some involvement with Evening on the Riviera, which benefits a couple beneficiaries in the area, too. So, yeah, the Frederick Gorilla is getting around. That gorilla, that hairy beast, he is getting around.
He gets around. We want everybody to know the gorilla. So, I mean, it's definitely important. All of us at the Gorilla, we definitely try to be we're trying to be more and more active within the community because I think you can never know too many people, especially when it's such a, you know, a small town
this.
It's definitely been a really exciting part of my job, being able to learn the people and the community. I'm new to the area, so I'm not from that far away, but I've never lived in this area. So to me, it's a really exciting place to learn from outside of being just a weekend visitor.
Sure.
People are, I have to say, this area is truly more connected than I've ever seen another area.
Yeah.
Everybody's like, everybody loves each other. They're very tight.
Yeah, it's very true. I am actually a native of Frederick. So this, you're absolutely right. This is very family oriented, business oriented, arts oriented. It's just a combo oriented
type
of community, and everybody looks out for one another. A lot of people collaborate together, you know, when it comes to business. There's a lot of really great stuff going on, and when it comes to nonprofit organizations and giving back to the community, I mean, I'm a big, you know, advocate of that myself personally, but a lot of people do that. They give back of their time and their energy and so forth to, you know, to really help these nonprofits in the area. So we are getting ready to go to another break. Can you believe it?
Wow, time flies.
I know, it does. It's very exciting. All right, so we will be back here, and we will wrap up soon with Bonnie Schilling from the Frederick Gorilla. Stay tuned.
Here is 1982. The Weather Channel debuts on cable. Cal Ripken Jr. starts his monumental journey of playing 2,632 consecutive baseball games, and the first ever Toyota Camry rolls off the assembly line. This is the same year that Mason-Dixon Public Auto Auction in Greencastle, Pennsylvania opened. For 30 years, Mason-Dixon Auto Auction has brought buyers and sellers of cars, trucks, vans, and SUVs together, saving everyone both time and money. Here's Sam Mason of Mason-Dixon Auto Auction.
It's been an exciting 30 years at Mason-Dixon Auto Auction. Since our first sale on May 2nd, 1982, we've sold over 500,000 vehicles. Everyone at Mason-Dixon says thank you for your business. And if you haven't experienced the action at Mason-Dixon Auto Auction yet, what are you waiting for?
The action continues every Tuesday night at 5:30 p.m. where dealers and the public can come, bid, and buy. Pay what the dealers pay at Mason-Dixon Public Auto Auction, Exit 3 off I-81 in Greencastle, Pennsylvania. See your next vehicle at MasonDixonAA.com. Congratulations, Mason-Dixon Auto Auction, on 30 fantastic years.
At Sidemind Creations, we take your ideas and turn them into reality. Custom t-shirts, vinyl banners, yard signs, bulk email design flyers, and more. Sidemind Creations makes you look like a marketing genius. Sidemind Creations uses technical expertise and our eye for design to propel your business to the top.
Hi, my name is Ray Wolf, and I'm the owner of Sidemind Creations. Small business or large, team, organization, or individual, call me at Sidemind Creations.
Sidemind Creations will create your message from inside your mind.
Hi, my name is Brent, and I'm the general manager at Roddy Creek Automotive, and I want to personally invite you to our new full-service automotive facility located on Route 15, just north of Thurmont on Roddy Creek Road. Our objective is to give you the best car care and customer service that you have ever experienced. Roddy Creek Automotive has a professional staff of ASE-certified mechanics who will put you and your car's performance first. We specialize in personal service, and we will pick up and drop off your vehicle at any prearranged location to get the first-class service that you deserve.
All right, we are back. This is Caressa, and I feel like I want to stand up and dance with all this great music we got with the segment today. It's awesome. So, let's talk a little bit about how people get the magazine, Frederick Gorilla. Really easy.
Really easy.
There's a number of different ways.
Yes. Well, we have them located in more than 70 locations on the website. Well, let's see, 70 locations listed on the website. So if you go to the website, or it's actually listed sometimes in the magazine, it'll give you a list of all the local shops and retailers and businesses.
Yeah, there's like a lot of restaurants.
Yeah, there's stacks everywhere.
Yeah.
So they're easily
different
found.
Fitness facilities, I know, have them.
Yeah.
Things like that.
So,
yeah.
But if people find them, because they go quick. I mean, that's the one cool thing.
Yeah.
They do go quick. You can get a free subscription. So you can get brought to your house for free, so you can just sign up online at thefrederickgorilla.com, or you can pick up, if you pick up a magazine, there'll be a card inside, so you can just fill it out and pop it in the mail. So we make it really easy, and then it's also available online in the App Store. You can get your digital edition for your tablet or your smartphone.
Yeah, the digital edition's great. You know, you just have to click, and it just flips
all
the pages
magazines
for you, and you can blow it up and read it, you know. So if you're one of these like techie people who sits on a computer all day, it's perfect for you.
It is perfect.
You don't need to have the paper copy.
Yes, you don't have to touch anything.
I know.
For your
I, however, have a subscription because I enjoy reading it, and I like getting it in the mail. And then, you know, I might have to skim through it, you know, periodically, like because I'm busy. You know, I'll like pick it up. Oh, okay. You know, when I have a little downtime or like in the middle of lunch or something like that at home. So
you can you can dog ear a page. You can tear out something.
Exactly.
If it's a cool recipe. I mean, it's definitely cool to get any of those ways, but it's really easy. And then if you miss an issue, they're all in the App Store. So when you download your app, you can go and look at, you know, all the past issues for free. So it's just easy.
Yeah, and that's great that, you know, especially if people miss it. But overall, the magazine is free. So any way that you supply it to them, it's free. They don't have to worry about, you know, paying for a subscription or anything. And they get to read about all the dirt.
Yes. I guess
all the controversy.
I guess we got them to understand that it's free.
Yeah, I know, right?
It's free.
It's free. Free is free.
We like free.
Yeah, free is good. Sometimes free is good.
Yes.
In this case, free is really great.
Free is really good.
Yeah, the Frederick Gorilla is great. Okay, so in addition, we did mention that Frederick Gorilla is published by Graphcom.
Yes.
And they are a company located in Gettysburg. And obviously Gettysburg is, not Frederick, but Gettysburg has a lot of historical value. And this year they are celebrating in the Gettysburg area the 150th anniversary of the Battle of Gettysburg. So there is a lot of stuff going to be going on in the Gettysburg area. And because Gettysburg is a hop, skip, and a jump, really, from Frederick, the spillout of the people is going to be enormous. So why don't you go into a little bit of detail as to, you know, what's going on, because there's a new publication that we want to alert people about.
Sure. We also, under Graphcom Publishing, we do celebrate Gettysburg, which is the local Gettysburg, local Gettysburg magazine. From that,
actually that's about 7 years old, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah.
It is, and it's great. It tells you all the ins and outs of places to go, and you know it's a really great little magazine. Mm-hmm. So along with that, we also have it's a special publication, the Dine and Entertainment Guide. And especially for this year, because of the 150th anniversary of the Battle of Gettysburg, it's going to play a huge role in helping these 4 million plus visitors mm-hmm. navigate Gettysburg and all the surrounding areas. I went to one of the meetings of the Visitor Center last week, which was very informative. They let us know not only about the 4 million visitors, but the average stay for a Gettysburg trip for a family is 5 nights, which is huge.
Yeah, that's I think it was
2, maybe 3 nights, but it's definitely a long time.
Yeah.
So,
well, they make a trip out of it. You know, families, if they're coming in and they're checking out all the history in this area, you know, you would think that they would want to travel around.
Yeah. And there's
coming to Frederick.
With that, for 5 nights, you've got to have a whole lot of meals for the family and a lot of things to do.
Exactly.
We definitely have to have a lot of things for the families to do while they're here. It's engaging them in whether it's dining, attractions, entertainment.
Shopping.
Absolutely. Yeah. And so there's going to be a lot of people looking for things to do and out within the Gettysburg and then on the outskirts. So the obvious place is Frederick. So it's an easy, like you said, a hop, skip, and a jump from Gettysburg. It's a straight shot across 15. So it's a really important publication to really pull from that 4 million visitors.
Mm-hmm. Right, and they're I know that they're going to be handing out some of these or having some of these distributed in the Frederick area. And, you know, that'll be great. A lot of businesses can take advantage of this, as well as the restaurants and the entertainment venues that, you know, the whole publication signifies, dining and entertainment.
Absolutely.
You know, because honestly, you never know while they're here. They might need certain things. They might be people who are coming into the area that are, you know, just live on the outside. Skirts too and don't know about some of the different things. So, you know, and Rely Local has partnered with the Frederick Gorilla, obviously, as a media partner, and we have adopted this dining entertainment guide to share that with our members so they can take advantage of advertising in it as well. So it's great, you know, for any Rely Local members that want to be a part of it, but any business that's in the Frederick, Gettysburg, Waynesboro, you know, wherever, they can take advantage of it. So
because one of the things I know that we learned from the meeting last week to talk about the extensiveness of this of the event this summer is it's really important for us to be good hosts, and that's from that the last thing you want to do is have visitors come into town and just not know what to do, because obviously Gettysburg cannot handle this kind of volume.
Frederick definitely will get some of that.
Yeah, so Frederick needs to really get some of this action.
Right.
So,
and from a tourism standpoint.
Sure, there's a lot of history here.
You need to have a lot of information, you know, supplied for the people that come into the area, because as you said, being a good host and letting them know about some of the things, it will potentially give them the idea to come back again.
Absolutely.
So that's,
and I think, you know, and I don't have stats for this, but I know that so many of the people that are going to be visiting, they're going to be driving in with their families. So it's not to say, you know, they may come in for a dinner or evening or a day trip with their family, but the next trip they plan, they may come here as opposed to going to Gettysburg.
Right.
This may be their main drive to destination.
Absolutely.
Since that's become such a popular thing.
Yeah.
So,
and I think the great thing is this publication, you know, we're obviously they're seeking advertisers, and the great thing is they have rates. Advertising rates are starting at $100, which is very affordable, and they're also doing installments, you know, where they can, you know, deal with the billing in a better way, and it's a digest size, which is really great. So
that's
throw
true.
It in a purse, a briefcase,
pocket.
Yeah, it's really, really going to be great. And obviously, space is limited with this size publication. So if anyone who's listening is a Rely Local member and interested in advertising, they can contact us at Rely Local. You can email me, Caressa, Caressa, at relylocal.com, or you can call me at 301-606-8935. But we're getting ready to end here, Bonnie, so I want to make sure that people know how to get in touch with Frederick Gorilla.
Great.
If they want to advertise in either publication,
sure.
you know, outside of Rely Local, go ahead and give the contact info.
Sure. I'll give you my contact information. It's bonnie@graphcom.com. And you can also find us on the web at frederickgorilla.com or celebrategettysburg.com.
Got it. Yeah.
So I would love to hear from you, and we'd love to get you in either the magazine or the guide.
Yes, that would be great. And they are also on Facebook, so become a fan and increase those fans that they have.
Please do.
All right, Bonnie, thank you so much for coming in today. We really appreciate it.
Thank you so much. It was fun.
Yeah, it was great. All right, so stay tuned, folks, for our next program, the Bobby Likas Car Clinic, sponsored by Rely Local member Roddy Creek Automotive. This is Caressa. We will talk to you next time.
Thanks for tuning in to Rely Local Frederick's Business Radio Spotlight right here on AM 1450, The Source. Heard Saturdays at 1:30 p.m., Rely Local Frederick's Business Radio Spotlight is a movement, a campaign to take us back to what makes America great. Businesses locally owned and operated by you and your neighbors. Thanks for spending your valuable time today with us.